One to go signal from Jason Dykes, and next time we'll go green. 10 laps, top four go to the main event. And if you do finish fifth, I guess it's not too bad because you're going to sit on the pole of the first last chance showdown tomorrow afternoon. So if there is any consolation out of it, at least you got a decent chance to get in. Top two from those consolations will go to the main event. Not going to be easy, though. You want to do it right here, right now.
Definitely. Plus X2 positions from the track, from the Fall Brawl Champion Series. But, man, Rick, get us fired up on this first heat race.
Out of turn number four, it'll be Owens and Bloomer. They've gone at it many, many times, and they're going to do it right now. Jimmy Owens with the slight advantage. Scott Bloomquist, high side momentum. And Owens will shut the door as Frank Ingram in a Bloomquist chassis now takes the third spot. Now Scott will look to the inside of Owens in turn number four for the lead. Nothing doing. Lap number one goes to the Osho.
The Osho, Jimmy Owens going to lead him back over to one and two while Scott Bloomquist in tow behind him. The rest of the field, but here comes Donald Mack trying to get up on a fast Frank. Austin Horton's trying off with the rest of them as they come out of three and four. Rick, referee.
Only four cars are going to go, Dwayne, and Donald McIntosh makes sure that he is one of those four as he works the inside now of Frank Ingram. He'll sidestep him, put him in his hip pocket, so he's one step further away from those back markers that are trying to charge into a transfer spot.
Man, oh man, what are these boys going to do with only a few laps running down in this heat race? Scott Bloomquist still cannot find the grip to run down the Longhorn of the 91 of Todd Dart. Excuse me, Jimmy Owens trying to get used to that car, Rick.
It'll be Todd Dart before it's all said and done as Jimmy Owens leads Bloomer along with McIntosh Ingram. First car on the outside looking in is Austin Horton in the 16. Now he's got some time. He was the fifth fast qualifier for this particular heat, but he's losing touch with Ingram.
Time slowly getting away from these guys, and here comes that Cant Daddy trying to work his way up to fifth. Him and Austin Smith and David Payne, man, they just got close together coming to it.
Five in the books, five to go. We're halfway through. He raced number one. Cant Daddy throwing all caution to the wind. He'll look high, he'll look low. Nowhere to go right now as he gets to the outside of the coach. So Cant Daddy trying to at least get a good starting spot in the concert if he can't make the top four.
That's definitely on the Cat Daddy's mind as he's now turned his sights towards Austin Smith, the seat of town driver, but Scott Bloomquist starting to run down. Jimmy Owens coming to the line.
Nothing here except starting spot in tomorrow's 60 lapper. If you win this, you're on the pole. If you finish second, Dwayne, it's fifth starting spot, so not too bad. Either way, it's a long race, and here comes Bloomer to the inside. He'll take a peek underneath with two to go.
The 2016 Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series champion. Getting things rocking and rolling. He's going to get a run out of turn number two. Now he's going to take a peek at Owens coming to the outside, to the inside as they come out of four. White flag out, Rick.
One lap to go, and it's still Jimmy Owens showing the way with Scott Bloomquist again. Looking high, looking low, just testing the waters to see how this car will react on the slick surface. He'll give it one last shot in turn number four for a shot at the pole. It's going to come up short. Owens is going to win it. Bloomer second. Third will go to McIntosh. Frank Ingram gets his Bloomquist chassis in. And like we said, now it's going to be pole tomorrow in the Concy for the 16 of Austin Horton. So not too bad for the young man out of Noonan, but nevertheless, your winner of heat number one. And he just continues to do well in 2016, helping Todd Dart out this weekend in the Dart Attire 91, the Osho Jimmy Owens.
So definitely not on for these guys that time around. Jason Croft, I know he'll love to pick up this heat race after setting a brand new track record 2 weeks ago here at Sonora Raceway.
And he's been good at this place and getting better as the year goes on, and you know he'd like to start up front in tomorrow's 60 lapper, because who's to say what could happen here? That's a long time around, but it happens in a hurry. But he's got David Brazil, who's in that 18 machine. That Franklin Enterprises ride is very stout. Let's see what happens.
You're very right. Here we go. Out of turn four. They jump to the loud pedal and they're off.
It was a great start. They were dead even. High side momentum for Jason Croft. He's got the bite. He'll go. Now Ray Cook will take a peek to the inside of Brazil. Chase Youngins is also working on the 18, looking to go three wide in turn number three for the first time. But it's Brazil that emerges second.
Right now, Brazil still sitting in second. The Tar Heel Tiger up under the Manhattan Madman. Mr. Chase Young is trying to get up on the high side and find some work, but here they come at you, Rick, out of four.
Well, all three drivers just mixing it up. Busier than four cats in a one-foot square litter box as they take the battle off into turn number one and two. Ellis on the outside looking in the 99 from fifth.
Ellis picked up the big win with the Southern All-Stars at Talladega Short Track. Would love to try to get back in that good slick ride that he had started up and coming, but caution now falls to Smith in three and four.
Two young competitors came together over in turn number three, and it was Austin Smith that tried to stuff that 84 underneath Joey Armistead. There wasn't enough room. Characteristic once it's been raced on. Different configuration, but still the same in the surface. And right now, liking the surface is Jason Croft, but it looks like Brazil's starting to get comfortable on the slick.
Let's see what the Mississippi man can do against Tomb Raider, former Dixie Speedway track champion, coming to the line as they cross the stripe. The field started to get kind of single file. They get going here, Rick.
Well, Jason Croft took the weekend off last week to go hunting with his son. He saw a couple deer. His son was sleeping while the deer were there. Jason said, I could have shot it. I wanted my son to get his first shot. By the time I got him woke up, the deer had had enough and took off.
Oh, man. Well, that's disappointing. But it looks like the old Tomb Raider might be one of those bucking deer starting to get away like Bambi tried to do away from the hunter in his story.
Well, if he can win this thing, he's going to start third tomorrow night as the winner of heat number two in Group A will get the third starting spot. So that's what they're going for right now. And it is definitely Jason Croft's race to lose as they work their way out of turn number four. Seven laps on the scoreboard, two to go next time.
And the Manhattan man is starting to get something working on the top side as he's starting to close up on Brazil. But man, look at those young guns going back at each other. You got Mr. Ashton Winger. Oh, Joey just made contact with the outside wall in two, Derek.
Joey Armistead just took the Clint Smith line around turns one and two. Wasn't able to pull that wild pony back in. It had to grab the reins last second. So two totally different lines. Winger all the way on the bottom. Armistead was on the top side, but the bleach flag comes out. We're one lap away.
Only one more time around for the field. As everyone is starting to take the white flag, the Tomb Raider, Jason Croft. Absolutely flawless in this second heat race, and he's going to come out of turn four and he'll see the checker flag come to the line.
No doubt about it. He's got it. It's Brazil second, Young in third, and Ray Cook will get the 15th starting spot tomorrow evening with that fourth place finish. So the second of four heat events in, and the train, Croft Heating and Air Conditioning, number nine of the Tomb Raider, Jason Croft, will start third tomorrow night. And Michael Page, who's not afraid to race anywhere in the country with his machine, so this should be interesting, not only the battle up front as well. So they work out of four. Heat number three underway. Let's see who gets into one first. Going to be over 10 early. Shane Clanton's going to use that patented high side. Michael Page and Massey mix it up, so they're two by two, by one by three as they work their way into three for the first time.
And out of turn number four, Shane Clanton. He'll lead that time around, but they're already three wide with Ryan King. They just made contact here on the front stretch. They get it back up and rolling, and everybody gets their eyes set back out front.
Zach Leonardi had the number five spot. Tyler Millwood took it away. Leonardi used the chrome horn. Up the banking goes the Millwood machine. So things getting a little bit rough here on lap number two.
Already things getting hairy. Mason Massey.
And Millwood's got a problem. The car won't turn left. It hits the wall in turn one. So the contact between he and Leonardi, something has gone wrong with the 31 machine, and it looks like left front flat tire. That's exactly what it is. On the restart, Clanton will bring him up to speed. As Perry Holman would say, he'll mash the loud pedal. We go back to green. How about Page to the inside of Overton? Battle for second.
And Overton's going to get back on the throttle and pull back around Page today. Cole's in the three and four. But Clanton, your Billy Clanton Memorial winner, he'll lead this time around with the laps clicking to click off.
And it looks like Shane Clanton wants to join Jimmy Owens on the front row tomorrow for 60 laps and 10 large. All he's got to do is just keep pointing in the right direction right now because he is pulling away from Overton. And Overton's trying to keep distance on Page, but Page under attack.
And racing Mason Massey to Douglasville, Georgia. Pair of Douglasville drivers were slugging it out. Mason had to get out the throttle. The asphalt spin starting to come into play. But Paige, the ultimate winner back here in August, is getting at it hard.
We are cross flags, five in the books, five to go. It's all clamped all the time. Second place all by himself, Overton. And again, Massey will go after Michael Paige over in turn number three. All the while, Ryan King, who started in the back, has worked his way to fifth, trying to sneak up on this battle for third.
And the God of Performance Warrior House Car 1G machine. Right now, if he can't close up and to Mason Massey and finish fourth, he's in a great starting position for the second B-Main coming up, Rick.
Tough shoes to fill for Ryan King. Think of the drivers that have been in Sanford Goddard's 1G machine throughout the years. Freddie Smith comes to mind, Rick Eckert. Of course, you had all kinds of great drivers.
Dale McDowell,
Scott James. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. Those are tough shoes to fill, and he better start filling them up quicker. He's going to the last chance because we're going white flag next time.
Yes, sir. Two to go. The Bullhorns are out on the third heat race. They're going to come and take the white flag for your race leader of the Georgia Bulldogs, Shane Clanton.
One lap to go, and all he's got to do is just keep the car moving forward. Brandon Overton can do nothing with him. So it looks like second place starter tomorrow night from Zebulon, Georgia, the Georgia Bulldog, Shane Clanton. Finishing second and starting sixth tomorrow is going to be Brandon Overton. Third finishing position, your 10th place starter, Michael Paige. And Mason Massey in the 15 comes home fourth. He'll start 14th tomorrow evening.
I know the Massey family very happy to see one of their fabled sons make it into the big dance and avoid the hooligan race tomorrow.
So let's see how this shakes out. Riley Hickman looking to pull away from the start. Not going to be so easy. Joe knows this place all too well. He's won here. He knows what it takes. Green flag.
So the four-time and defending Southern All-Star Series champion drives away, but they're going to go three wide right now to turn number two on the race already.
They went after it on the green flag. It was Riley by himself, and a Hornet says, oh, look out. That is not going to fly at all. Caution waves.
So Focher and Hunter Peacock.
Final four starting spots from preliminaries tonight work their way out of turn number four, and his fourth heat is underway.
Off of the turns one and two, they're getting back at it. Riley Hickman on a three wide, and we got one around here in turns one.
That'll be Shane Fulcher bringing out the caution, so the Fulcher family has got their fair share of yellow.
Here we go, the green flags back out. They're going to get it in the turns one and two. Riley Hickman definitely keeping up the flawless starts as he's getting away, but Joe Armistead was a lot red this time. We got one off the pace and on the back stretch. We stay green so far as Riley Hickman leads lap one.
And lead he does as Joe Armistead will try him down the back stretch. Nothing doing there. How about TJ Reed? Looking very solid early. Glenn Morris, the speedy hippie right now running fourth.
Oh man, perfect name for Morris driving the Jim Hare on number 27 machine as they go into turns one and two. This will be the biggest field that Glenn Morris will make in his career so far in super late model competition. But Riley Hickman's starting to feel the heat off Joe Armistead coming out of four.
Well, you got to feel that Armistead's got the home field advantage. It's just a matter of can he pull the trigger in 10 laps. We're going to come down for lap four, so he's still got plenty of time to figure it out. But Riley Hickman has gotten a lot better in the slick track as of late.
Yes, sir. Riley Hickman, one of these slick specialists. Basically has won on all the slick tracks the Southern All-Stars has visited this season, and he is still showing the way around this speedway so far.
And so far so good, but the door is open in turn number four. If any kind of bike can be had by Joe Armistead Jr., he's going to take advantage because he's got the door open all the way around. Riley mid-track, Joe Armistead down below, but just can't quite get through there yet.
Definitely Riley Hickman's got that CVR car really working well against the rocket chassis of Joe Armistead, but he would love to do something for the local boys here tonight if he can make something work with four to go, Rick.
So we start to work in on the end of heat race number four. Joe Armistead Jr. hasn't given up yet. TJ Reed solid right now in the third spot. That fourth and final transfer position could be under protest. Lanny Fulcher starting to gain some ground on one Glenn Morris.
Glenn Moore is pulling double duty, running limited late models as well as supers. Time starting to slip away with the bullhorns are out on the Matador out front of Riley Hickman.
So it's white flag the next time by, and Riley losing a little more of the handle, but Joe Armistead just can't get off the corner. He gets in fine, he can't pull.
Oh yeah, Joe Armistead still one of the best hammer down drivers, still getting control of this slick stuff. White flag out coming to the line.
Final time around for Riley Hickman as he'll just sail down the back chute. No contest, nobody on the rear bumper. Joe Armistead's going to have to settle for second. Riley Hickman wins. He'll start fourth tomorrow. Joe Armistead Jr. will come home in that second spot. Great run for TJ Reed. Very impressive. And at the line, Glenn Morris hangs on, and he will race in the biggest race of his late model career.
Yes, sir.
Harrison Hall out of Circleville, Ohio, did not return with his 99, so 8 cars, 10 laps, top 2 go. Who's it going to be? We'll find out shortly. On the hammer to come out of 4, we're underway. And it's going to be Derek Ellis early. Here comes Clint Smith. He knows he's got to get top 2. And he's going after it. Already up to 3rd. The Cat Daddy clawing his way. And here comes Winger. Aston Winger in the number 4 spot. So Cat Daddy and Winger carving their way through the field early. 1 in the books and 9 to go. Ellis showing the way. In that second spot is the 16 of Austin Horton looking to get in the dance. Now Joey Armistead coming to life on Winger. Cat Daddy first car on the outside looking in, but maybe not for long. The door is opened by Austin Horton, and it's up to Clint Smith to walk through that threshold. Now Armistead will look to the inside of Winger as they battle for 4-3. Will go on the scoreboard. It's Derek Ellis showing away. Austin Horton second, Clint Smith third. Now a gaggle for the number 4 spot, which will do nothing but get you bragging rights, and that's about it. Winger holding off Armistead along with Smith and Smith and the coach David Payne. Talked to David Payne this afternoon. He said, I'm pretty much in the show. My points, all I got to do is ride, make sure nothing falls off, and don't get in a wreck. And he's a little too close for comfort with these 4 cars mixing it up right now. As you just never know with these guys fighting as close as they are. David Payne is right there. If something happens in front of him, his strategy may have went out the window. So past the halfway point, 7 will go on the scoreboard. 2 to go signal when they come back by. And it is definitely a dogfight for the number 4 spot. Sitting in provisional spots right now is the coach David Payne and Ryan King in the 1G. So Payne obviously is going to get the 21st starting spot with this particular run. Up for grabs is position 17 and 19. 17 right now belongs to Ellis, 19 to Horn, but here comes Clint Smith again. White flag in the air this time.
That was 10 laps.
Well, it's going to be a 12-lap affair, we understand.
Is this 9 right here?
Here's 9.
Oh, there it is. Now lap 9 is up. There we go. That's better. 1 to go for Derek Ellis. Scoreboard did not change the daylight savings time and fall back. So we've got that caught up now. Derek Ellis gets the win. Here comes Cat Diddy inside of Horton. Ellis, your winner. At the line, Austin Horton will hold off the Cat Daddy. 2 more cars go to the big show. It's going to be Austin Horton. He'll get the 19th starting spot. 21st starting spot is going to be the coach, David Payne, as he'll take the first provisional. And the winner of the first last chance, starting 17th tonight, out of Chatsworth, Georgia, in the Ellis Contracting, AutoZone Jeans Racing Parts, and Stealth Carburetors, number 99, the Ditch Digger, Derek Ellis. Pretty much anybody's guess who the top 2 are going to be. Ryan King has a provisional in his pocket if he needs to use it. If not, Doug Smith in the 45 will get the nod. So this is a big race. Out of 4 they come. 3 wide. And King just opened up the door for Leonardi. So the caution comes out and we'll do it all over. Race director Chris Tilley says, gentlemen, side by side, If we can't play well with others, somebody's getting a carpet square of chocolate milk and going to get timeout. Green flag. Better that time. Ryan King on the inside, Leonardi on the outside. They battle side by side down the back stretch and into three. Zach Leonardi with a pretty good run. The young man in the 24 getting a hard shot out of turn number four, but King will answer back. Leonardi and King stay side by side. Now it's Leonardi by a car length as he clears the 1G down the back stretch. Now Ryan King sits in the hot seat, and it's up to Billy Franklin to try and figure out how to catch him. Zach Leonardi in the 24 getting the job done here. And Ryan King knows he's in the show, doesn't really want to start 22nd. If he finishes where he does, he'd start one row up in 20th. So that's what's on the line. And everybody else just trying to figure out what it is they can do to get a spot in this main event, because spots are at a premium right now. Four go on the scoreboard, halfway next time. And Doug Smith in the 45, pretty much banking on the fact that Ryan King is going to transfer. If that is the case, then Ryan King will help that 45 out immensely. Halfway, five in the books, five to go.
We know.
So this is it, the final two spots plus a provisional up for grabs, and that is all. The Zaxby's Sonoma Raceway scoreboard says we get two to go next time. Speaking of chicken, must be time for Dwayne to eat again. We mentioned food, he's heading to the concession stand. He's already had one of everything, he's on round two. White flag in here next time by. So Zach Leonardi is going to look at position 18 if we can hang on for one more circuit. White flag in the air, one to go. Field of 23 is going to be set if everything stays status quo. Checkered flag's going to wave. Leonardi will win it. He'll start in the 18th spot this afternoon. Ryan King will get starting spot 20, and Doug Smith, with his persistence on the series, will get the 22nd starting spot. So your winner of the second last chance showdown on actually September 4th, Labor Day at Tazewell, it was the coach David Payne. September the 30th, Davenport won his second bonus series of the year at Tri-County Racetrack, and it's time to get up on your feet, boys and girls. You need to rise for this one, and you need to enjoy it, because they are four wide, the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Bonus Series. Everybody get up.
Come on! Get up!
Yeah! Four wide!
One of the most beautiful sights in all of motorsports right in front of you guys. Duck River for the Deep Fried 75, October 15th, went to Mr. Smooth Billy Moyer. And the most recent race at Ponderosa on November the 5th, Easy E, Eric Wells, pulled off the big win. So that is how it is shaken down for 2016, the 11th race of the year on the series. And Donald McIntosh on his way to go. And the rule is they have to run one race per calendar year in order to be grandfathered in as a racetrack and continue to operate as a racetrack.
That's correct, brother. They have to at least run one, but the lights are out, Rick. We're about to get a burn burner show going here.
And they are, as my good friend Joe Linebarrier, known as Joe Dirt, would say, the field in lockstep formation as they work their way into turn number three. Jimmy Owens on the inside, Shane Clanton on the outside. The green flag from Jason Dykes comes out. It's showtime!
Scott Lucas goes around in one and two. He overdrove it, got a little help, and look what he just caused behind him.
He did the exact same thing at East Alabama last week, but did it on the backstretch and kept going. This time it's different. He does not have his hockey skates on yet, therefore he did not get going.
Not at all, not.
There's nothing better than 2, 3, 4 wide, sliding through a corner at full speed, turning the wheel to the right while the car goes to the left. There's just nothing better.
That's it, man. And once it's in your blood, I don't think you can ever get it out. But like you said, Rick, lights are out. We're about to do it again, there, brother.
Well, let's go. Second verse, same as the first. Let's see if we can get through turn one with no calamity. It'll be up to Owens and Clanton to bring the field to life. The thundering herd starts to get louder. They roar, they roll. Here we go. And so the test is on for turn one. Can everybody get through? Looks like that's a success. We're finally underway and off into turn number three. Shane Clanton's going to take lap number one. Owens will look to the inside. The Georgia Bulldog will lead the first circuit.
While Shane leads the first lap, Jimmy Owens in second, third place. Riley Hickman, but Scott Bloom is already on the move as he'll pass Michael Page. 2, 3, 4 wide on turn number two. These guys are already getting up on the wheel early.
You knew it was going to happen. It's just a matter of getting comfortable out on the racetrack, finding what works, and don't do what doesn't. And a good battle going on right now between three cars, being Jason Croft, Donald McIntosh, Joe Armistead. They mix it up three wide out of turn number two. Definitely three distinct grooves early in this one.
Yes, sir, and definitely Brandon Overton's going to open the door. Here comes Black Sunshine, dipping it down into the ooey-gooey sticky mud. Can he make it stick? Wheel-to-wheel, hub-to-hub in the 3 and 4, Rick.
Still a battle going on for the number four spot. Overton has it. Bloomquist wants it. Overton's got the high side momentum. Bloomquist has the preferred line. Now Bubba will change. He'll test the waters. He knows there's 56 laps left. See what works early. See what doesn't. And then go to the chalkboard and maybe drop one more plan.
Yes, sir. Right now he's under attack by Michael Page. The Douglas V of Dynamite. Diving out under Bloomquist, trying to show the top man in the country. This is how you play in my background there, buddy.
Well, Michael Page may be showing his hand a little bit early. 5 of 6 to end. Bloomquist decides to go way upstairs and see what's in the attic, see if there's anything worth using. Now he'll come back down and oh, he just threw the people's elbow to Michael Page. Page didn't take too kindly to it. He'll go back after him in three.
Michael Page just let Bloomquist know he wasn't quite happy with that flying elbow, Randy Macho Man Savage style, and he's coming back under him as Bloomquist has found that patented high side groove here, Sonoya.
And finally, the lap cars start to go on the list. Doug Smith, the gentle giant, is going to be the first one to go underneath Shane Clanton's reign, and that'll be it. 45 goes a lap down. Still, Jimmy Owens running second with the R1 of Riley Hickman all over him for the runner-up spot. Riley's got a good line. Let's see if he can make it happen.
The Hustler has had many great runs, and he's going to take over the point out of turn number two. And a four-time Southern All-Star champion coming after Newport Nightmare. Jimmy Owens out of four. Jimmy's running him up the track, man. These guys are getting at it early, Rick.
Yeah, and early going for second. They're not even within shouting distance of Shane Clanton right now. Just 10 of 60 in. And you think they were going for 100,000 to win on the final lap. These guys want a shot at this thing. They know season's running short. And if they want to get out of here with some momentum for next year, they got to do it here.
Yes, sir. Riley Hickman looking for redemption after dominating both times when the Southern All-Stars made their appearance and only to fall short within the last few laps. He's approaching his rival, Shane Clanton. And it's about to get good with the most wanted list sitting in the back waiting on your leader there, Rick.
And all of a sudden, Riley Hickman, Jimmy Owens, and what's probably going to be Brandon Overton are going to get a shot at Clant because now he has to slice his way through this field, try and put him a lap down and put some lap cars between himself and the second place car. Right now, there is nowhere for Clant to go. You got Horton high, Payne low, so it's going to be real tough on the Georgia Bulldog.
You're very much so, man. Riley Hickman still trying to throw the hook out and reel that big fish in as they ride into turns one and two. But man, oh man, great racing so far. And Michael Page closing up on Brandon Overton for the fourth position. They head into turns three.
Scott Blomquist has been riding the rim around Sonora Raceway, and he's starting to build up momentum. So Black Sunshine may be covering this field before it's all said and done. Look at Scott. He's the only one that stays right up by the wall.
Because he knows that in order to get around him, you have got to find a different alternative route. He's got the GPS pointing north towards the lead, and he is riding these boys down.
He figured it out that this could be a momentum-type racetrack if he can hit the corners. That time, a little too high, wide, and handsome between one and two. Lost a little real estate, but goes right back to work as far up the racetrack as he can go.
And right now, these guys still trying to slice and dice in Hell's Kitchen with the lap cars. Riley Hickman now has finally got Shane Clinton back in his sights. But Michael Page up under the Newport Nightmare. Brandon Overton is down in the picture for four.
Jimmy Owens has lost sight of the second place car of Riley Hickman, and he's trapped down low. He's got Michael Page to the inside. He's got Overton behind him. Blomquist not too far out of shouting distance. Page may be the fly in the ointment. Oh, it'll be huge if he can win this.
God almighty, Riley Hickman to walk Shane Clinton down. They're now getting ready to square off, coming out of turn two. Nothing but a car length between those two. If they go into three and four, the battle for the lead is about to erupt here shortly.
So Michael Page continues to dig down deep and low like a dinosaur looking for our eggs as he continues to gain real estate. All the while, Jimmy Owens has got a hard-charging Brandon Overton and a persistent and relentless Scott Blomquist up top. It's either going to bite Blomquist into shorts or it's going to propel him up front. We're waiting to see.
Raz, right now we're seeing what Scott Blomquist got in mind, but man, Shane Clinton, what a move in the lap cars. That just put some big distance between him and Riley Hickman as Riley knocked on the back door before he split the lap car.
That could have been disastrous for Shane Clinton. He took the gamble and paid off and got him some real estate between himself and second place Riley Hickman. Michael Page is broken free. He's going to try and chase down the R1. There's a couple lap cars separating him. All the while, Blomquist continues to hover as caution comes out. Donald McIntosh, the point leader, Spring Nationals champion, is in trouble in turn two.
Definitely. Donald Mack was having a top 10.
And it's been a very, very productive 2016.
Yes, that young man still won the upcoming stars in the dirt late model ranks. You'll probably be hearing more and more about him as the veterans like Billy Moyer and Chubb Frank, I think next year's his last year.
Or Shane Clinton will sling it and bring it. We go back to green. Michael Page just took Hickman by storm, and Hickman threw it out the window. Riley Hickman just tossed it out the window like it was trash, sideways after he got passed by Michael Page, tried to recover, couldn't hold on, and the R1 will go to the tail. 50-50, what a perfect weekend. Shane Clinton on the green.
Off into turns one and two. They're going to pipe it up. Look at Scott Blomquist on the high side, and he just got cut off. That's going to kill the momentum going into three and four, Rick.
He had a heck of a hole shot out of turn number two, only to find Brandon Overton right there. It happens again. Blomquist is going to stay on the loud pedal and try and make it work out of turn two. Page to the inside of Clinton for the lead. Michael Page, the underdog of the year. Oh, Blomquist got a piece of Owens.
Man, pushing and shoving. Ric Flair elbows getting dropped around this speedway. Woo! The Nature Boy coming out of Michael Page. He's all over Shane Clinton. Down into turns three and four. He tried to dive, And Shayna come out wide while Michael's trying to get back to him.
That Andy Durham engine of Scott Blomquist is singing at full song. He is getting a whale of a run out of the corners. If he can just get the bite out of the tires, he's going to have himself a rocket ship. He's not been able to corral the power yet, but he's working on it. Speaking of working, Michael Page working all over Shane Clanton for the lead.
And he continues to come after the Georgia Bulldog. Those guys got a narrow win against Auburn Tigers earlier tonight.
And Riley Hickman's got a problem. It is leaning over heavy on the right rear. You're seeing tire smoke coming out of the R1. Don't know how long he's going to last, but Riley Hickman definitely has a problem. That may have caused why he spun.
Yes, sir. That's definitely a huge reason of what could have happened. But now Shane Clanton has gotten back control of the race and getting away from Michael Page, and the field is getting single file from this point on. But right now, the closest battle between the pair of nines, Jason Crawford, Fast Frame.
And another battle taking shape as Chase Youngins to the inside of Blomquist for fifth. Chase Youngins out of Manhattan, Kansas, had a great weekend last weekend in East Alabama, and again, he's showing it here.
Man, oh man, Scott Blomquist. Oh, just tagged up against the wall, and that's going to light up Manhattan Bad Boy to get up on it. But Scott Blomquist got it rolling hard, trying to fight him back coming to the line.
Things have settled down for now. Business is going to pick up when Shane Clanton reaches the lap traffic, because once again, he's going to have to dance with the slower cars. That's going to allow second place Michael Page, third place Brandon Overton, and fourth place Jimmy Owens to close back in. They've got to keep him within the sights while he closes in on these slower cars.
Two laps past halfway right now as we're on lap 32 of the 60 laps, and Shane Clanton again watching lap cars. But back and further, man, these guys are putting on a show for the fans. Not a person sitting down nowhere here in Sonoy as these guys continue to click them off.
Well, things are going to start to get interesting here shortly. Shane Clanton can now see the back markers. First in line is Austin Horton. That's going to allow Michael Page and Brandon Overton to close the gap. Real estate at a premium here right now for Page as he's got two lap cars side by side in front of him. That's slowing his momentum.
And things continue to run around the speedway as the bottom groove has now become the dominant groove. So far, the high side is slowly drifting away. Scott Blomquist about in no man's land up there, trying to hold off David Brazil as they battle it out for six.
So Brazil comes back to life somewhat as Shane Clanton just got by Ray Cook. Now has set his sights on both Derek Ellis and Austin Horton. All the while, Michael Page has really closed the gap down to five car lengths. So once again, we're going to turn the page and see what it reads.
Michael Page, the page turner right now. The Page Master.
Overton just got into David Payne and looped him. Payne was in the way of Overton. Overton used a chrome horn and just moved Payne out of the way. So the coach just got fired.
Definitely the defending Southern National Bonus Series champion. Gonna pretty much end up in second once the points shake down after tonight and tomorrow.
Right now, it's still 18X that's turning heads, impressing, and continuing to go to work. Let's see what happens. Close quarters on the start. Frank Ingram comes back to the racetrack. He wants to play in the clay a little more. Now Jimmy Owens decides he's going to try for third. He'll go after Brandon Overton over in turn number three there. Side by side there, Trayton Bate. Jimmy Owens three wide with Chase Youngins. Oh, he stuck his nose in their business. Made it a three-car party, but came up short.
Definitely everybody's trying to scrounge around in Catfish Pond at the bottom of the speedway. Gonna take a nice friendly dip and see what you can grab, but man, oh man, racing still so good here at Speedway. Scott Blomquist has not let out the high side, not once yet.
You just gotta wonder if maybe he's heating the tires up to go down underneath somebody. He ran the top side, now he's pulled it down low. So there it is, he takes the dive. Let's see what he does here and rides for the next 21 laps. I don't think he's gonna, right back up to the top. So some drivers like the attic, the others, they act like a Picasso at the bottom of the aquarium.
man, oh man, that's just something crazy, Rick. And as much as they're working with it, but man, Young hands up to four, but Owen's gonna retake that spot quicker than that man can decide which way to chainsaw.
Well, I'll tell you what, the transition for Owens from fifth to fourth was quicker than Bruce to Caitlin.
Definitely, without a doubt. Bloomquist still up there riding the backside, chasing it like a Kardashian's backside. What a race here tonight here at Sonora Raceway. I'm loving this tonight, Rick.
And we got wide open racetrack for the next 18 laps. Shane Klein has put some distance between himself and Michael Pace. So obviously in clean air, clean racetrack, Shane Klein the more dominant car in that Capital race car. Michael Pace, however, if he can get him in lap traffic towards the end, who's to say?
There's so much online. Joe Armistead Jr. making a hard left into the pit areas. His night has now ended. And still the bottom. The fast, fast way right now as everyone is transitioning down into the catfish pond.
Normally the shortest way from point A to point B is the bottom of the racetrack. But if you're like Bloomquist and got some momentum, maybe that pays off at the end. So far, Scott has not been able to climb up very far. Sits in the number five spot for now. Shane Clanton, actually in sixth spot for now. Shane Clanton has got himself a straightaway on Page. But lap traffic is in front of the leader.
Here we go. 14 laps to go as Shane Clanton will cross the stripe this time by. Michael Page, Overton in third. Fourth, Jimmy Owens, fifth. Chase Young hands sixth. Scott Bloomquist, seventh. David Brazell, eighth. T.J. Reed, ninth. Riley Hickman, and tenth, Zach Leonardi.
How about the Zach attack? Zach Leonardi winning the last chance showdown number two. And the young man who didn't think he had a chance of getting in yesterday, he said, man, I'm starting way too far back in the last chance. Well, look what happened. New life, new attitude, and a top 10, baby.
And only 15 years old. Oh, yeah, he's definitely a 15-year-old phenom. Great young man out of Cartersville, having a great run tonight, but the racing continued to slack down with 11 to go this time by.
Michael Page is reeling in. Clint, Shane Clanton bobbled. Here comes Page. 10 to go this time, and Michael Page has cut the leader. Also, Brandon Overton has gotten into the mix. A three-car party for 10 grand and 10 laps to figure it out.
Hello, hello, dinner for three as these guys have closed up. Oh, Michael Page, God almighty, he just tried to put that thing up on a Clanton.
Clanton got sideways, had to reel it in. Michael Page got on the binders, could have forced the issue, saved both cars, and one more shot to win this thing with 9 to go.
Less than 10 to go in this one. Michael Page doing everything he can to run down the Georgia Bulldog. But there's only so much time left in the hourglass now, Rick.
Yeah, and you just got to wonder with Shane Clanton bobbling, is that handling gone? Because there's Page to the outside of Clanton. He brings Overton along for the ride. Three cars under a blanket for the lead as they head into three. To the outside is Page. To the bottom is Clanton. Here comes Overton. Here comes Owens, and here comes Youngins.
God almighty, the fans on their feet. They are going ham right now. The turn-up dial is getting real. Michael Page is now to the front, and he's getting away from him. Oh, man, Shane Clanton now has found the groove, and he is running away from these boys at this point.
That may have just sealed the deal. Shane Clanton just pulled away from the lap traffic. It's clean racetrack. There's only six to go. So if anybody has anything in the bag of tricks, they better bring it out, and they better start spinning it because we're running out of time.
Each lap right now, Shane Clanton acting like Houdini at the Magic Show. He is just making these boys disappear each and every lap, inching by inching away from the rest of the field.
Said the brakes come out at night.
Yeah.
4 laps to go for your leader, Shane Clanton, and he's got to be feeling a sigh of relief with open racetrack. And now what appears to be just 3 circuits left. Michael Page has lost touch, so has Overton, so has the 18 and the 91. My goodness, what a battle that was with about 10 to go.
Yes, it was, man, and these guys are finishing out a very, very strong and productive race. They're about to grab the bullhorns, 2 to go for Shane Clanton when he comes out of 4.
White flag the next time by Shane Clanton.
has two laps to go. Michael Page has closed the gap, but I don't think he's got enough sands in the hourglass. We're going to find out as we get one to go this time.
The Georgia Bulldogs got across the stripe. That's just too much sauce on this field. That man is just oozing and goozing, showing out tonight as he has been the dominant force. And nobody going to think they can touch this man. Just a really bad mamma jamma there, Rick.
Well, it's a Georgia Bulldog win in football and a Georgia Bulldog win here tonight at Sedona. Shane Clanton wins second to Page. Third will go to Overton. Fourth to Youngins. Fifth to Owens. We'll go talk to the top three.